Let's talk about some horror manga that are not by Junji Ito. Stay tuned. I love Junji Ito. In fact, I have a whole video where I went through his entire bibliography and talked about all of his releases, including stuff that has not yet been released in English. However, I know that when people are looking for horror manga recommendations, many people are kind of tired of getting the same recommendations over and over and over, and Ito's work kind of overly populates many of those lists. And as amazing of a series as Uzumaki and Gyo are, and as terrifying as Tomie was the first time that I read it, there are a lot of other series out there from other creators that I want to talk about. So in this video, I'm going to be talking about 6 different horror manga that I really enjoy. And these are from all kinds of different subgenres of horror, and as well, they come from many different decades. So we have stuff from as early as the 70s all the way to things that are currently still being published. So hopefully we're gonna find some things that are some great recommendations, maybe some stories that you haven't heard of yet, or some stuff that you have heard of and have not quite gotten into just yet. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump on into it. So first I'm gonna be recommending Go Nagai's classic Devilman. This is from the early 70s, and while it is quite an older series, it has aged magnificently, in my opinion, of course. Now, if you're familiar with the Devilman Crybaby anime that's on Netflix, it is essentially just a modernized adaptation of the original series. And if you enjoyed that, then you'll probably enjoy this as long as you're open to reading classic manga. However, for those of you who are not familiar with Devilman and its story from any of its adaptations or from the original manga, the story basically takes place in a time where the demons have come out of the underworld and are invading the earth. And one such demon has invaded the body of our protagonist, Akira Fudo. Akira Fudo then gains the ability to transform into Devilman, and he decides to use his abilities and his power to fight against all of the demons that are trying to destroy the earth. Now, if you've seen the anime, you know exactly where the story goes, but if you haven't and you don't know anything about it, I'm not gonna spoil anything for you. Go Nagai is one of the most well-known creators in the medium. And his work, specifically his work on the Devilman franchise, has inspired so many different creators throughout time. His very signature style and the way that he creates these monsters and demons that he uses in these titles has influenced many different artists, such as Kentaro Miura with his work on Berserk, as well as Norihiro Yagi in his series Claymore, as well as many other creators with many, many other dark fantasy and horror manga. Now, if you're looking to enjoy a Devilman manga but want more of a modernized take, there is actually a more modern adaptation of the original series that's been published by Seven Seas as Devilman G or Devilman Grimoire. This is similar to Crybaby. It is a modernized take on the original series with more modern artwork and a contemporary version of the original story. However, in my opinion, while the artwork is nice, the narrative itself is not the best, and I would much more recommend just reading the original series from Go Nagai. Next is another classic from the 70s, and that is creator Kazuo Umeze's Drifting Classroom. Now, this entire series was republished just recently across 3 beautiful hardcover oversized volumes under Viz's Viz signature line. So if you are like many people like myself who missed out on the original paperback editions of the series, these hardcovers are fantastic. And if you'd like a detailed look at these hardcovers and detailed thoughts on the story itself, I actually did last year do a review of the entire series that you can go and check out. But to briefly go over the story for the recommendation in this video, mysteriously an entire school vanishes. The inhabitants within the school, the students and the faculty, find that the school has all of a sudden appeared in what seems to be some sort of apocalyptic wasteland that's occupied by many grotesque and monstrous threats. Throughout the series, the students and faculty must do whatever it takes to survive against these threats. However, as many of these types of series go, threats tend to develop within their group themselves, and the students see themselves having to fight against one another as well as the members of their faculty who are working against them. It's a fantastic horror series that relies not just on the horrific imagery, but also the horrific things that happen to these children throughout the story and what they must go through against the various adults and against each other to try and make it out of this situation. This is a really beautifully told story that was essentially Umeza's vision as a child after seeing the bombs drop, imagining what a post-nuclear war Japan would be like. If you have not read The Drifting Classroom, I highly recommend it. It is a fantastic manga and one of my absolute favorite horror stories. As well, Kazuo Umeze is a big inspiration for Junji Ito, so if you are a fan of Ito's work, Umeze is someone you'll definitely want to look into. Unfortunately, even though he's had a very lengthy career and has published many works throughout that career, much of it is not available yet in English. And aside from Drifting Classroom and a series that we have upcoming next year, not much of his stuff is actually currently in print either. So I'm hoping that as we go forward, Viz will add Kazuo Umeze to the number of creators that they lend very specific focus to, amongst others like Junji Ito, Naoki Urasawa, Taiyo Matsumoto, and Rumiko Takahashi. And speaking of Rumiko Takahashi, she is the creator of the next recommendation on this list. Now, while Takahashi is known for many of her other romance series and comedy series like Urusei Yatsura, Ranma One-Half, Meisan Ikkoku, or of course the Inuyasha series, she also had a romantic horror series that was published sporadically across a number of years, titled Mermaid Saga. Now, in Japanese mythology, it's believed that if you consume the flesh of a mermaid, you may be granted immortality. However, there is a greater risk that eating the flesh will instead kill you or turn you into a horrific monster. In Mermaid Saga, we follow Yuta, who unwillingly ate flesh of a mermaid and did, in fact, gain immortality. However, Yuta is weary of his immortality and is on a quest now to find a mermaid so that he may consume their flesh and be granted back his humanity. Along the way, Yuta meets Mana. Mana is a young woman who has been turned immortal by a group of older mermaids who are hoping to devour her flesh so that they may regain their own youth. Yuta saves Mana and they continue along on this quest together. Now, Mermaid Saga is not a story that's going to keep you up at night. However, it is a beautifully told fairy tale that reminds me a lot of the classic Grimm's fairy tale stories. Now, if you're already a fan of Rumiko Takahashi and any of her other works, you really owe it to yourself to pick up the recently released two-volume series that Viz put out. Next up, we've got something a little bit different. It's very different. And that is Shintaro Kago's Dementia 21. Now, for those of you who are not familiar with Shintaro Kago, he is a surrealist and absurdist Guro artist. And if you're not familiar with what Guro is, you might want to go Google that, but just keep in mind you might find some pretty not safe for work results. However, essentially, let's say body horror. Now, Dementia 21 is really a comedy series. However, the comedy of the situations that the main character finds herself in are juxtaposed with the surrealist artwork of Shintaro Kago. The story itself follows Yukie Sakai, who is a young woman working as a nurse towards many elderly people. She's just trying to do her jobs, but these strange situations keep coming and happening around her. These strange situations I don't really want to spoil, because a lot of what I enjoyed about reading this story was just the shock that you get from the very strange, absurd, eerie, and dark artwork that Kago inserts into this series. But suffice to say, things get weird. Now, if you're interested in picking up Dementia 21, it is available from Fantagraphics Books across these two oversized paperback volumes. Next up, we have a psychological horror series, and this one doesn't rely on any monsters or killers or anything like that. However, it is one of the most honestly terrifying series that I read regularly, and that is Blood on the Tracks by Shuzo Oshimi. Now, if you're familiar with Shuzo Oshimi and his other works, then you're probably familiar with a little bit of what you're going to see in this series. But for those of you who are not familiar with the story, essentially it focuses on an extremely overbearing mother and her child. Seiichi is just a normal young boy in Japan who wants to live a normal life. And one day, his entire family, including one of his cousins, goes out on a family trip. And as they're playing in the woods next to a cliff, Seiichi's mother comes along and sees Seiichi's cousin fooling around at the edge of the cliff. She goes to rescue him before he falls, but at the last second decides to drop him, and he is very seriously injured and winds up falling into a coma. Now, Seiichi knows what he's seen, however, he nor his mother are saying anything to the rest of the family as she's letting them believe that this is an accident. Now, as the series progresses, the relationship between Seiichi and his mother becomes terrifying as she becomes obsessed with him to levels that are beyond unhealthy. At the time that I'm making this video, the series is still ongoing in Japan, and we have 6 volumes available in English, with the 7th just around the corner. The last recommendation in this video is a horror comedy manga that is as equally frightening as it is hilarious, and that is Mieruko-chan. Mieruko-chan follows our protagonist Miko, who just wants to be an average high school girl living the average high school life. However, she can see spirits and ghosts and ghouls around her. So her solution is to just ignore these spirits that constantly are appearing around her. Much of the comedy of the series does come from Miko trying to ignore the monsters who appear around her and act like everything's normal. However, these monsters are just artistically represented as terrifyingly as possible, which honestly is something that in most horror comedies, they tend to not push on the terrifying imagery as much as they could. For instance, I love Zom 100, however, Zom 100 is never a series that really creeps me out with its imagery, whereas on the other hand, Mieruko-chan does. The monsters and ghouls and spirits and whatnot that appear on the pages of these series are legitimately terrifying looking, which just increases the comedic aspect of the series, because the more terrifying these monsters are for you, the viewer, that means that it's harder for her to ignore them in front of her, and the comedic aspect of her trying to ignore them grows. Of course, the series does develop an ongoing plot, and it's very entertaining. I really enjoy this title. I know that an anime has just recently premiered for this series. I haven't watched it or heard much about it. However, I highly recommend the manga. It is fantastically funny and terrifying at the same time. So I'm hoping with this quick list of recommendations, I found something that either you haven't heard of before, or maybe if you had, you hadn't jumped on it just yet. These are all series that I greatly enjoy, so these all come highly recommended from me, and I hope that if you do try and pick one of these up, that you do wind up enjoying it. Thank you so much for watching this video and spending time with me. If you enjoyed it and are not yet subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and subscribe and hit that bell so you're notified of all the awesome content that I put out on a weekly basis. I hope that everyone has a happy and safe Halloween, and I will see you all on the next one. Peace out.